A series that served up plenty of surprises. MasterChef Australia had incredible locations with huge names like Gordon Ramsay, Nigella Lawson, and even a member of the royal family, Prince Charles. But the grand finale episode was also full of emotion, laughter, and joy. And it was Sashi who ultimately took the crown for MasterChef Australia 2018 with the record-breaking score of 93 out of 100. Wow. Check it out.
Sashi, you are Australia's MasterChef for 2018.
Welcome, Sashi, to Studio 10.
Stars. Well done.
Thank you so much, guys, for having me today.
Sashi, can I just say, I actually did ask if we could use a glitter cannon for your work walk-on, but apparently it's an OH&S issue here these days,
and we couldn't get it happening. A lot of cleaning up to do after that.
That's right. How are you feeling? What a ride.
It's been amazing, right?
Yeah.
So many new people I met, so many new cuisines I've explored, desserts I've learned. The judges has been so amazing. I gained a lot of knowledge from them. I learned a lot. It was I went to a new school, and I learned new stuff, and I'm going to implement whatever I've studied into a new world now.
He was such a people's favourite as well. Like, I don't know if you're the bookies or the expert's favourite or the queen's favourite, but people just loved you. You were so humble. You know, you seemed to care so much about everything you were doing.
Maybe because I come from a very big family that we really share a lot of care and concern for each and every one of us at home. And being the eldest son in the house, I become like a fatherly figure for most of my siblings.
It comes
out naturally most of the time.
Yeah. I don't know whether anybody knew. I just had a talk to Sashi before we came on. It's a 7-month commitment. Mm. Did you know that?
Yeah. Well, we can actually find out a little bit more about what happened behind the scenes on MasterChef after the break. Now, he's only been wearing his MasterChef crown for a bit over a day, and we have him on the panel this morning.
Yay.
We're so excited to have Sashi, the MasterChef winner, on our panel. Can we talk a little bit about your previous life? I am so fascinated by this. Before you became MasterChef champion, you were actually a special ops police officer in Singapore. And in fact, you were part of the Special Tactics and Rescue Unit.
Yes, I was from there. I was there for 7 years.
Wow.
Out of my 12 years in the police force, 7 years I spent in Star Unit.
So counter-terrorism, VIP transfers.
Yes, anything that is high profile, I'll be there.
You're like Bruce Willis.
Not really, but it won't be seeing my face because I'll be always in Black Ops, so we'll be covering our face pretty much, no one
That's
knows.
Right.
Yeah.
That is so
cool. And you just go home and make a nice curry at the end of the day or something.
Yeah, something like that.
Wow.
And nobody knows what I was doing because we're not allowed to talk about it.
Oh.
Other than my immediate family, but now I can speak about it because I'm no more there.
Oh, so you're like James Bond almost. Jason Bourne.
The smiling is Jason.
what was your cover story then?
Oh, cover story
If you weren't allowed to talk to anyone about being in special ops.
What did you say you did?
What did you say you did?
I say I'm just a police officer doing that job. That's it.
Yeah. So Sarah found out about it. During the ad break, Sarah found out all this stuff. And the first thing she did was go to Sasha. She goes, "Did you ever kill anybody?"
No.
And he didn't.
And he didn't.
He didn't.
Although, of course.
Not with a bad prawn.
That's right. He wouldn't
either.
Tell us.
But there's a couple of interesting things I've done. Pretty much a lot of adventurous stuff, jumping out of a plane, you know, all that stuff. It's all part of training, you know. I'm airborne, diving, name it, everything I've done.
Like a Navy SEAL.
He is Jason Bourne. You are Jason.
And then you came here, you worked in the Justice Department.
In Victoria,
And then you ended up as a prison officer.
Women's prison in Adelaide.
Now, without going into too much, but there's been a whole bunch of controversy here about prison officers and prisoners sort of,
being friendly, conjugating.
Did you ever hear of that happening? Of course, you would never do it yourself.
Yeah, definitely there have been cases like that. Really? But you, as officer, you have to draw a line.
Of course. Mm.
You can be friendly, but they're not your friends.
And no. How would it even happen, practically speaking? Like, how would it, like, where would it happen?
Oh, love finds a way.
People can be very manipulative. They really talk you into things that you don't want to get involved. People can, if you are not mentally strong, you can be sucked into it very easily.
So would it be in like common areas or in cells or?
You really want the graphic
details. Not necessarily in the prison. It can be outside also.
Really?
Yeah, but I would say it's very small percentage.
That's enough of that.
Very rare.
Yeah, very small percentage.
Don't you tell him anything that you don't want to.
No, I'm just curious because it reminds me of a movie I saw once. And,
Let's talk about your MasterChef victory.
Oh, heaven.
Tell us about what went on behind the scenes. Denise mentioned that it's a 7-month commitment, so it's a very long journey, a long process.
Actually, it's more than 7 months.
How long were you away from your family for?
Away from the family was about 6 months.
Wow.
Yes.
Yeah, I didn't realise that.
Is that really hard?
Yeah. Because the filming is one part, then after that, the interviews, the IVs and all that, it's all be on a different days. So it's longer than what you see in TV.
Oh, yeah.
Wow.
Yes.
They edit all the time. But you got to go home at Christmas and then at Easter, and that would have been too hard on the kids as well. And,
and we had a short break in between, a couple of days during Easter and Christmas. Personally, I didn't like it because I'd rather stay away all the way than go back home to them.
Yeah.
That few
keep
days
your head
at
in
home.
The game.
So being a MasterChef, you actually had less freedom than working in a prison.
I was in a prison. No internet, no phone calls, only limited number of phone calls in a week. So,
but better food.
Oh,
better food.
Better food, obviously. We enjoyed cooking. But it's just want us to be focused in one thing that is food, and that's the result you get.
Was there a moment on that journey where you thought, wow, I actually could make it to the end here? Was there a moment where you know you were getting immunity pins all over the place? You were covered in them at one stage. Was that kind of the moment where you thought, wow, this I'm in with a chance?
I think the second immunity pin. After the second immunity pin, the confidence level was pretty high. I believe in myself much more that I will be able to pull through till the end. But the last final week was a bit shaky for me.
I know. Oh. It was like it took a turn and we're all going, because you were my favourite from like day one. I'm just going to be unashamed in saying that. I loved everything you did. I felt like it was smell-o-vision. I could smell what you were making through this. Because you were so descriptive with the spices and I could see so many things. It was just magic to watch.
What about the judges? Everything you put out,
they
nearly licked the plug.
they love good flavours. So for me, flavours has been everything for me since day one. So it worked out pretty well.
Was confidence a problem? Because I was with Andrew, I was watching you from the very beginning. You're one of the few who really stood out as being someone who was so natural and human. Yeah, but you didn't seem to... Like, you were very good, but you didn't seem to have that confidence early on. Like, you seemed to be...
Yeah, I had my doubts.
..racked with doubt.
Pretty much because of the plating and the rustiness of my kind of cooking. Mine is very homely, very rustic cooking. I like to have big portions, share platter, that kind of stuff.
None of that nouvelle cuisine garbage.
Whereas MasterChef is a bit more finesse, you know. They like to have nice plating. So that is the doubt I had, but MasterChef taught me that, you know, anything is possible if you know how to work around it.
Sure. You broke the record on the night with 97 93 out of 100. That's just amazing.
That's
incredible.
Oh, I never thought about that. I went in with the same thing every day in my mind to cook the best possible food on the plate. Mm. I did that and the results were amazing.
How much do you think as well? Because the MasterChef kitchen is just so pressurised and people just lose their cool and lose their minds in that situation. How much of your special ops training do you think... I love it. Just getting back to that sort of thing. How much do you think that came into play?
It does help a lot most of the time.
Mentally.
Mentally, it prepares me. At the same time, when I go back home, I reflect on it. And I'll work on whatever problems I have, which was all I learned from my previous job. Mm. How to reflect, how
strategy
to get... Strategy. Yeah, strategy.
Okay. Which is more stressful, the MasterChef final or doing a counter-terrorism operation?
MasterChef final. Because counter-terrorism, I can plan, I know what I'm going in for, whereas this, I'm blindfolded. I got no clue what I was doing until I see that reveal of the dish.
Oh, unbelievable.
Just brilliant.
You are just a beautiful bloke, and you're sticking around, and you're cooking for us a little later as well.
I'm cooking a simple dish for you guys.
Wasn't it the first one you cooked?
No, I've not cooked this in the show before. Oh. So it's something different for you. Especially for you guys.
Okay.
Now, applications are open now for the 11th season of MasterChef Australia. So if you have dreamt of working in the food industry, this is your chance to shine. To apply, head to the MasterChef page on template.com.au. And there's only one more week to apply. What would you say to people maybe thinking about it?
If you have a dream and passion, please go for it. Don't hesitate. I didn't hesitate. I take a risk, and here I am.
Now here he is.
Right.
Sashi, everyone.